Oh, panel, it seems like everything old is news again. Thanks to Omicron, I feel like I am in the worst kind of time loop, where everything just keeps resetting except I visibly age and still accrue debt. So, with that in mind, let's play a game of Deja News. Here's how this works. I'm going to play each of you a news clip. You have to just tell me if it happened this week or 1 year ago. Oh, Miguel Rivas, you are up first. Can you tell me, is this current news or Deja News?
As you know, like in other provinces and countries around the world, on case counts are rising exponentially across the province. Now, we're bracing for impact.
Who was that?
I believe that's Duggo Ford.
You are correct. The KC counts are rising exponentially. For the point, was that from this week's news or a year ago, Deja News?
You know, I believe that that was from this week.
You are correct for the point. This week, the Ontario Premier announced last-minute closures to schools, indoor dining, gyms, and capacity limits for retail, which he also did at exactly this time last year. Now, let's do the Deja News for a point. What did Doug Ford mispronounce a year ago when he announced the stay-at-home order?
Last year, what is it? He mispronounced everything.
Instead of Ontario, he called it Ontariario.
I believe he was talking about school, and he pronounced it kindergarten. Is that what he said?
All these are plausible, but here is what Doug Ford mispronounced at this time last year.
There is no confusion here. It's very simple. Stay home. Restay à la maison.
Restay à la maison.
And weirdly, he was correct. We are restaying à la maison. Exactly 1 year later.
I feel like I'm transported to Paris under the Eiffel Tower with a baguette and a bottle of wine.
He's just so sophisticated.
He should be bottling his... He should be putting what he says in a bottle to make up for what the other girl, you know, that lost the business.
Folks, I'll do anything to raise money for healthcare workers. You can buy my farts in a jar on Ontario.ca.
And my farts come from my mouth, he
says. According to the Toronto Star, kids in Ontario lost more in-class learning than any other place in North America.
Yes, Ontario topped another list. That's what we want. I want to be in first place. You know, my daughter, she's in senior kindergarten now, and she did all of junior kindergarten on Zoom, and I did it with her, and so it kind of feels like I'm being held back a grade, but it's not even a grade, it's a kindergarten. So I failed kindergarten, and I don't feel proud of myself.
Can you draw a star?
Also, my son is a daycare age now. He was a baby last time, so he just kind of lay there. And now he's really disruptive in senior kindergarten, let me tell you.
CBC ran with the headline this week, Canada's flying blind with Omicron as COVID-19 testing drops off a cliff. Panel, are you cliff diving this week?
Oh, yeah. I find myself singing in the house, Omicron, hada farma, E-I-E-I-O.
Oh, I'm going to use that for kindergarten.
Use it. Omicron.
We had that reprieve. I was going out. I went to see shows. I was having dinner unmasked. I was like, I got through this. And then it was ripped from us.
Moving on, Martha Chaves, it's your turn to play Deja News. Have a listen to Quebec Premier François Legault.
The situation in our hospitals is critical, especially in Montreal. That's why I'm announcing that starting next Saturday, there'll be a curfew from 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. during 4 weeks.
Do you get grounded if you stay out past curfew?
Yes, you do. Added for the point, was that announcement new or old? In other words, was it current news or Deja News?
It's Deja News. He said it last year because I think the curfew this year is at 10 p.m.
Ooh, you are on the money, Martha Chavez. Whoa. That is Deja News. That announcement was from January 6, 2021. CBC reported that Quebec is one of the few places in the world to impose a pandemic curfew, let alone do it twice.
Wow. Look, the nice thing is we're growing up, right? So as we mature in this hellfire that is our lives, we get a few more hours to stay out, which I think is really nice.
8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Yeah. You can see a movie, but you can't go to the theater. You could have dinner, but you can't go to a restaurant.
This year, Legault had to make an announcement about a curfew again. Here is Legault with the new announcement.
I'm announcing a curfew from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. starting tomorrow night. places of worship will have to close and teleworking remains mandatory.
But what does he mean? The what places of worship are open after 10 p.m.? Like, where? I don't know. Like, and who is worshiping? Unless you're worshiping Satan, there is nothing.
What about midnight mass? Midnight mass.
You're not one of those night Catholics. Days after the announcement, the Quebec government had to add an exception to the curfew due to public outrage. What activity can you now leave your house to do in Quebec after curfew?
You're allowed to go to Saint-Viateur to buy fresh bagels right from the oven.
That's my place of worship.
Or you can just go to La Poutinerie and you can take your dog with you.
Well, you're correct about the dog. If you take your dog, you're not breaking curfew. The headline from the Montreal Gazette is Quebec backtracks plans to allow dog walking after curfew.
That's why there's all those dogs in the strip club. Everyone needs to go out there and just bring their dog.
That's discrimination against the pet list. So if you have a dog, yes, you get more fresh air. A humbug.
Gavin, you walk your cat everywhere. You're a criminal if you do that.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if the cat would count. Like, he really needs a walk. Trust me. Yeah. Other exceptions are going to a gas station, separated parents transporting kids to the other parent, and going to the pharmacy to get sanitary products.
Woof, even in this pandemic, I have to go see my ex with the kid? Jesus.
Even in this pandemic, I have to deal with my period?
This is the perfect time to send, like, a guy out to get your sanitary products, because they'll be just happy to get out of the house. Check out the entire episode of Because News by subscribing on iTunes, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts.